Hey guys, Hobbs here. You just got Bran Bronzebeard, essentially the Baron Rivendare, but for the Battle Cries. Couple cards that immediately came to mind that would be OP would be, of course, Dr. Boom. Dr. Balance, as people like to call him, just got a, not a debuff, but an actual buff. Fill the board with four Boom Bots. That's insane. The Twilight Drake for the Handlock. If you can get this out beforehand for that one extra card, think of how big you can build your Drakes. Antique Heal Bot. Fantastically, not only one of the most powerful neutral healing cards in the game, with Bronzebeard, it is now much more effective. One I was thinking of off the bat too was Deathwing, because he would clear your hand twice, which is already clear, but it would also kill everything on the board twice, which things that have like Death Rattle respawns, would you kill that? But the question is, because Bran got destroyed, would your Battle Cry proc twice still, even though part of your Battle Cry kills Bronzebeard? Unfortunately, upon me making this prior to it actually being out, this is all theory, but a lot of these cards that we're going to take a look at will fit awesomely within your decks with Bran Bronzebeard. Another overpowered card will be Enhanzo Meccano. The Mist Collar for the Chamois, man, that's going to rock. It already rocks, and think of it now. Lotheb, not only could you barely cast anything, now you're definitely not casting anything. Nefarian, great in your Priest deck, which we're going to look at later, because I mean a lot of your dragons have battle cries, like drawing extra cards. Also for Chamois, the Draenei Totem Carver, going to be huge. This card is definitely adding a lot to the game. So one tip I want to show you guys, if you have Bronzebeard, the best thing to do is go down and type in battle cry. That will only work not only for this expansion, but for future expansions. So what's happening here is you can see which classes have which items with battle cry. Now, one that I thought of that would be OP is this, because you're going to gain 2 mana crystals, but you're only going to get the death rattle once. So even when this dies, you're still up 1. This one, give a friendly beast, looks like plus 6 health. I don't think you're going to be able to choose. And that's the thing that's going to be different, is when you're choosing, this thing's going to be redundant. I've already looked at that, because you're going to transform this minion to a 7-7. It won't be a 14, because the way it's worded, it's not you're giving it plus 7, it's you're transforming it into. Hunters have a lot of battle cries, which is going to be awesome. 2 random beasts. Like, I mean, there's so many strong things that are going to be random minion plus 2 attack, or 2 randoms plus 1. You know, it's going to be interesting to see how the draw already is a long process, revealing a minion. It's going to happen twice. You can possibly get 2 cards versus 1. If your other mechs gain plus 2 plus 4 attack, plus 4 plus 4. Like, I mean, this guy is so cool, so overpowered, definitely well needed. One that I was thinking of that would be really good would be Crowd Favorite, okay? Because, yes, he's not going to proc twice, but you're going to have a lot of battle cries in there anyways, so you're going to see him played a lot more as well. We each get 2 spells. The next secret you play this turn costs 0. Looks like it might only happen once, because you're only going to have 1 next secret. This thing, 4 damage. One thing that's interesting is, what if you kill a mech in the process? Like, let's say you hit something with low health, like a boom bot. Is it going to proc twice, because then the conditions won't be met? That's going to be things that we're going to see in actual gameplay, which will make it interesting. You can only, and the other thing too is, when you're choosing, are you going to be able to choose multiples? Like, can I change 2 enemy minions to attack to 1? Because a lot of these buffs are good. I was talking earlier about dragons. Dragons are going to be big too in the priests. We'll take a look at that in a moment. Next dragon you play costs possibly 4 less, which would be pretty rocking, especially since the great dragon consort doesn't see much play, but it did last expansion when it first came out. This thing I was looking at, it's actually going to be not going to change at all, because you can only have 1 secret of anyway. So even if it did it twice, you still only have 1 secret of each restore 14 health to your hero. Lots of cool stuff that's going to happen with this one. So with the Dragon Priest is already a strong deck. It's going to get a little bit stronger because of when you're holding a dragon, gain plus 4 health. That's a big turn one card. But hey, you can't turn it one because you got to actually summon him. So it's not turn one, it's turn maybe 4. But that's still really strong turn 4 for one mana, considering you might even have two of them in your hand. And you're going to have two fives in your hand that then you can buff, which is pretty solid. If you're holding a dragon, gain plus one attack, so that could be a 3-4. So you get plus two attack here, doubling it up there. Deal 4 damage to all undamaged enemy minions. That's a huge AoE all of a sudden. That's huge AoE. There's a flame strike for the rogue. Wow, that's unbelievable. This one I mentioned at the beginning, going to be big. Summon two totems, all of a sudden we're filling the board a lot faster. He's going to be probably one of the most overpowered cards in this game. And he's such a cheap cost at 3 mana. Obviously the flame imp would suck. Deal 6 damage to your hero. Discarding would suck. Discard 4 random cards. Discard 2 random cards. So there's certain cards you wouldn't want to play with him. You destroy your hero twice and replace him with Draxus twice. Deal 2 damage or 1 damage. 2 to all other characters. Really solid there. Just remember not to play the other warlock cards. So here would be plus 2 attack. Once again, good with it. We're seeing a lot more Dragon Warriors as well. Deal 1 damage to a minion, give it plus 4 attack. So you do it twice, right? I'm wondering, because you're choosing, if you do it once and then maybe do 1 damage here, and now this guy has plus 4. These are things that are all going to, once this is live, it's going to be unbelievable. Give a friendly mech plus 4, plus 4. And the armor's already gaining so quickly with warriors lately. Ever since they nerfed the Patron Warrior, it seems like warriors are getting, you know, by the end of the game, plus 30 armor. So, I mean, that's going to be insane. Gain 10 armor. Just looking, like I said, typing in Battlecry, you can go through all the Battlecry and just gain the attack equal of your weapon. Speaking of that, Pirate Rogues are going to be strong. Because you can basically gain double the attack equal to your weapon, right? Not only that, with Rogue, Shady Dealer is going to be strong as well. So Pirate Rogue could be a combo. You could actually combo it up with nicely. The Youthful Brewmaster and the other Brewmaster and a lot of cards like Shadow Step and anything that returns your friendly minions to hand are very handy in a Battlecry deck, because then you can cast them again. If you have something like Crowd Favorite out, well then with Crowd Favorite, he's growing quicker. But not only that, if you have Brand Bronzebeard out, he's also now triggering their Battlecries twice as you're bringing them back and playing them again. I mentioned this in my last video where we talked about Reno Jackson. So guys, make sure you check out that video as well. I'm going to cover all the legendaries here on this channel, so make sure you hit the subscribe button. And I basically bring all my highlights from my Twitch live stream at twitch.tv/wowhobbs here. But right now I want to kind of see what combos we're going to make in this next expansion. Mill. Strong, 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 strong mill. 4 cards each player. Wow. Wow. That's solid. Bring it back to your hand. Play it again. 8. Bring it back. Put it back. Bam. 12. Burn a couple. Bam. That's solid, solid, solid milling. Wow. It'll be interesting to see if BGH, if you can target one, then target another. Man, that'd be great against handlocks when they got their 8-8 giants out. Molten giants. Boom! Boom! Get rid of them both. Mind control tech. If he only has 4, he's probably not grabbing the second one. So that might be the thing, is if the condition isn't met by the time the second battle cry rolls around, I don't think you're grabbing another one. But once again, That's going to be something we're going to test when live. I'm really loving this card. I think this is my favorite one. I'm going to have Battlecry decks, definitely. And another thing to key to do is see which one has the most Battlecries just by typing in Battlecry below and checking. You know, this is how I craft decks, guys. I basically take a look at it and logically think what would be good synergy together. And then you look at the mana curve of it all and figure out, you know, do I need more draw? Do I need all this? Overpowered here. I wonder if you're going to get two awesome inventions. That could be crazy. You could get double of the draw. You're going to get two of the poultry things and they could just poultryize each other. Yeah, it's going to be a fun card for sure. This one in a priest dragon deck or even a warrior dragon deck will be strong. Four random spells. And interesting, if you could do this twice, you could not only maybe heal yourself if you're below 15, but also minimize his if he's above. Or maybe you just have to hammer yourself twice or vice versa just to, so that, you know, you don't bring yourself up or down. And that one's huge as well. One thing, include uncraftable cards. One thing is when you're searching this, I should have mentioned earlier, make sure you hit the crafting because here we got to go through a couple more. Hungry Crab. Question I've always had with this is it going to destroy two Murlocs and gain +2/+2 for each one? Or, you know, if there's only one out. So you have to click on this to see everything. Give your opponent four bananas. Also good for milling to keep his hand full of useless garbage. So you can go back and get him some Cold Light Oracles. So that one's a good one. If you have a minion with spell damage, gain +2/+2. At least if you have at least four other minions, deal four damage. What if you damage one of your own? And then you only have three. Does it proc again? Why would you damage your own? Because you have Cho on the field. And Cho is giving away all your cards. You're going to get two Power Cord cards. That'll be fun. I've got him. Destroy your opponent's weapon and draw cards equal to its durability. You can only destroy his weapon once, so that won't proc twice. Add two random paladin cards to your hand. Destroy two minions with taunt. Deathwing, that's one I talked about earlier. It's going to be awesome. Magnixia's not going to change because she fills the side of the board regardless. Guys, this is honestly going to be one that I'm absolutely looking forward to crafting some really cool decks. I've already made some Battlecry decks that you guys have seen featured on my channel. So this is going to be that much more awesome. So also some of the new cards that are out, the Discover is kind of like tracking where you get a choice of like three and you choose the best one. So things like the Gorillabot A3, you're probably going to be able to discover two of them. Two mechs or the Tomb Spider, discover two beasts. That'll be very interesting. Arch Thief Raphaim, who I'm going to talk about in a future video, you're going to discover two powerful artifacts of his. Reno Jackson's going to be useless. You're going to fully heal your power twice, so it really won't matter if it gets healed to full again immediately. The Ancient Shade you want to stay away from because though it's very powerful, it does have a drawback, so you might get two cards shuffled into your deck that can possibly deal seven damage when drawn. Now, guys, in my next video, we're going to talk about Elise Starseeker, and guess what? She's got a battle cry that shuffles the map to the golden monkey into your deck. Guess what? With him, that procs twice. Now you have two maps to the golden monkey. What is the golden monkey? Well, oddly enough, the golden monkey has a battle cry. And that battle cry says, replace your hand and deck with legendary minions. Now, unfortunately, it will probably proc twice, which means you might see some legendary minions and then it procs again. And you get them all replaced with some new legendary minions. But still, this is OP, which we're going to talk about next. I'm hoping you guys enjoyed this. I'm going to bring out more of the legendaries here on this channel. So click on them to see that. And make sure you hit the subscribe. I'll bring out some more card combos. And I'll bring out my best games from twitch.tv/wowhobbs. And guys, As long as you keep watching, I'll keep making it. Thanks again. Till next time.
Hopefully, I made a new deck today. Just before I logged on. And here it is. Let's give it a shot. It's a Warlock deck. I'm kind of using it a little bit. I had one of these last season. But we didn't have the crowd favorite. So I'm kind of using the crowd favorite. The power leveling guy. What's his name? The questing adventurer. And we're wanting to get on a rotation using the brewmasters and the summoning portals. And want to get it going. And we'll see how it works. Got some early curve to it. The archer. Nice. This is just something perfect right here. I think I'm going to keep it. Looks like a typical zoo deck to someone else at the beginning. It's not. But I do need that early presence. So there is some zoo-like options at the beginning. But the main thing we want to do is we want to get the other machine in order. So in order to do that, I got to solidify the early board presence. I don't have any AoE, unfortunately, in here. So I have to get that early board presence. Otherwise, it's game over. Why do you call? What's going on, Tiger Girl? How are you doing today? Welcome to the stream. Well, now, I'm going to start with this guy. And we're going to go face. So far, we've got a nice start. Weird that the hunter didn't put anything down last turn. He's coining, though, now. To put down. I think I'm going to go with the both next. That way, two daggers to the face. Yeah. There we go. Ping, ping, in. Okay, so we're already got him down by 7. But I'm needing to get this questing adventure out. What's going on, everyone? Hello, everyone. Got lots of people here. Thank you. I didn't stream yesterday. I did work on a lot of YouTube videos, though, yesterday. Excited about the BlizzCon this weekend, too. Some of the announcements. 1, 2, 3, and that. Okay, so we got rid of his weapon. So this questing adventure has a better chance to live right now. Portal or this. This for sure. And face. Now we got to start drawing. We got to start drawing, putting things out. Silences. Silence I may or may not keep. It depends how useful he becomes. Haunted Creeper, pretty useful right now. That's not so good. Well, we got to get this guy up above. Let's see what my next card is. Let's go with this. We're going to lead with this because it might be too tall. And if it is, I want... It is probably too tall, so I got to focus on this, and I got to start making it grow. I might be able to sit back. Ooh, nope. If he takes this thing out, he's going to want to take this. Okay, that's handy. 4. Can't do both of them. So... Let's go with this. And this. And just sit back for a turn. Sit back for a turn here. Am I going to see the new Star Wars? Sure, for sure, when it's out. Put this apple on your head. Do I know if the championship will air on Twitch tomorrow? I don't know, but I'm assuming they would. Either that or on if you got the Blizzard pass. Okay, come on. Deal 3 damage to this. buff him up a bit.
Pathetic to fight your own battles.
Kill this. Silence. I kind of want to silence it. If I go for face, it's going to drop it down. Let's silence. Because I'm hoping that the RNG from me casting this, but then, you know what? Let's just kill it. And let's pop this bubble. Toot off. Okay. So we got one guy out, guys. We got him down to six. We got him down to six. We got the portal and the crowd favorite. Is he gonna finally kill this thing? Or not? He might not. Mm-mm. He's going face like a hunter. So many viewers. Silence. Well, I'm kind of wondering if it's two to all, so let's see if we can get lethal. Let's put this beast out here. It doesn't matter what I silence. I'm going to buff her. And I'm going to buff this guy again because of this. There we go. Now I got Wind Fury. So as long as it doesn't return it to my hand, which it doesn't. We got lethal. We got lethal. What a good first game. Wow. See what I mean? That was fun. Oh my goodness. That was pretty awesome. The RNG paid off. I'm actually going to write that one down. First game of the day. Guys, if you enjoyed this and you're new here, make sure you hit the subscribe button so you can see many more videos coming out in the near future. And to all my reoccurring viewers, thank you all for sharing all my videos. There's been a huge increase in views, and that's all thanks to you guys. It's motivated me to make more content for you. So I just want to say thank you again. And guys, till next time.